Everybody wants to hear you.
You guys never give up peeling your eggs. Keep peeling your eggs and never give up.
Absolutely.
Welcome back to Makings by ChanelDijon. And I have my amazing co-host today. I actually have two. This is the first one. This is Connor Dijon. You say hello.
Hi, everybody.
Yes. And then I have my grandmother today. She will be here to help me because this is her recipe. So you actually have some generations right here, right?
Good afternoon, everybody.
Awesome. Okay, so today we're having a mini cook-off because we are doing double eggs, and this is actually originally Grammy's recipe.
I make sure look easy, but they don't know what it take. Don't ask me the time, I got baguettes in the face. Jojo drops on Louis, I want everything he made. When it comes to hoes, I never be the one to save.
So we are going to have a cook-off, and we're going to have Connor be the judge on to who has the best devil eggs. So today we're going to start off with, on my devil eggs, what I use is, I actually have tried to cut back on my dairy, so I've been substituting my mayonnaise with Vegenaise, and it's by Follow Your Heart. It is the best mayonnaise on the market for vegan.
I actually have a blender.
And we have a blender, thank you. This is actually called a food processor. We have our parsley, green onion, green bell pepper is all we will be using. Pepper, of course. Salt, you need your eggs. This is our wine today. This is from Costco, one of my favorites from them. I literally die for this wine. I love this wine from Costco. This is really good. And we also have our Old Bay seasoning. We will talk to Grammy about how she started making this recipe because this recipe is amazing. I mean, with my tweets, it just takes it up 10 levels.
But okay, I will.
At her pace, it's good for beginners.
You know, I really don't know exactly how I first started with the deviled eggs. I think I kind of remember. We were going to one of the cousins' house for a gathering. Everybody was bringing something. I couldn't think of what to do. I said, I'm going to make some deviled eggs. I'm going to try this. And I just started using different seasonings. Before I know it, we'd go to other places and they'd say, here comes the egg lady. Where's the deviled eggs? And that's how I got started with doing deviled eggs. So let's see if we can get a good shot of this. The way it's cut, how it's
cut. And that is, what's all in there? Let them know what's all in
here. What's in here is bell pepper, green onions, and parsley. Cut very fine.
As you can see, mine is not cut fine at all.
But the way she can do that is, the way she's cutting it, she just puts it back all together and takes a knife and just chops down like that. And it makes it, it'll make it thinner, smaller, and the juices will come out of the bell pepper. Not the green onions and not the parsley, but the juice from the bell pepper really does something to the deviled eggs.
Yeah.
She's doing a great job.
I am doing a great job, but you know who else is gonna do an even greater job? The food processor.
Yeah, and that's why I'm gonna press the blender.
Absolutely. So how about we take a sip of our wine first. And then we get started on peeling our eggs.
Really just comes right off. This is just the greatest, this vinegar, the little salt. Just crack it, take it around. Pulls off just like that and the whole thing comes.
If you guys poke a hole in the egg, which I tend to do sometimes, that's completely fine. And also, by the way, you guys, I recommend you boiling an extra egg because you're gonna end up messing that egg up sometimes, or a egg up, Couple of eggs. Yeah, a couple of eggs. So it's always good to boil extra. If you don't need them, give them to your kids, your dogs, your neighbor. Leave them in your husband's car if he makes you mad. Just kidding. I already messed up an egg, and this is why I say, look at this, guys.
It's okay. Everybody makes mistakes.
See?
Excellent.
Look at that. You guys see that parenting right there? Awesome.
Everybody wants to hear you.
You guys never give up peeling your eggs. Keep peeling your eggs and never give up.
Absolutely.
Very good.
And after we did, I finished my egg.
Are you done with your eggs? Because I'm done with mine.
I finished my egg right here.
You have a helper.
I'm done with mine. So
you have a helper.
Yes, very good. Now go ahead and drop it in.
How many eggs did you have?
Thank you, my love. One of the things that...
See how that came off?
I got to help me is an egg platter. This helps and goes so well with doing eggs.
Wait.
Absolutely amazing.
We want to see if we can.
Grammy, where did you get this egg platter from?
Oh, I got it from one of the stores near my home.
The 99-cent store?
Dollar store, Dollar Tree.
I know my grandmother so well. I knew it. It was either the Dollar Tree or the 99-cent store.
Exactly.
It's a Dollar Tree.
Oh, you guys
want
to know a fun fact about my grandmother? She actually was so frugal that she would never buy me a cheeseburger. Could you guys believe that?
Oh my God.
But she does buy candy for us.
Yes, she does buy candy for my children, but I would bake her on Wednesdays. I'm not sure if you guys remember. Grammy, maybe you remember. How much were the hamburgers? I think they were 50 cents on Wednesdays at McDonald's. 50 cents.
And a dollar for the cheese.
And a dollar for the cheese.
But I had cheese at home. So we didn't need to get cheese.
For a cheeseburger. Do you think that Grammy would buy me a cheeseburger? No. She would buy me the hamburger.
We have both grandmothers that bring us mints. Yaya, that has mints in her room. And Grammy, that has mints in her purse.
Yes, I am cutting the eggs right now because you're going to want to cut them in half.
And you're
like
going to want to take the dough out with the knife.
The yolk. Take the yolk.
The yolk, baby.
Yes.
Gonna wanna put the yolk in a bowl and put half of the egg right here. This is Makings by Connor Dijon, not Chanel Dijon anymore.
This one out, okay. And put it in the bowl.
Okay. Would you like to tell me what else to do? What do I do next?
You keep cutting the eggs.
Okay.
And taking the double out.
Okay.
Until you're all done.
All right.
You get the blender and mix all of your things in there.
Oh.
All of your ingredients.
Ooh, wow. You are the smartest 5-year-old I know.
Thank you.
That's amazing.
Yes, I am pre-K.
Yes, you are in pre-K. And you use such a good word. So we're going to just add everything in here. All of our green bell pepper. Exactly. All of our green bell pepper and our parsley and our green onion. We're going to just throw that on to the bowl, right?
Mm-hmm. And we're just gonna slide into the bowl.
Not yet. No, not yet. We gotta mix everything up, right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Go ahead and just use, I'm gonna say a big scoop of mayonnaise. So you wanna just do a big scoop, about that size.
It's like an ice cream.
Yep, it is. And just start mashing and mixing. Mash and mix. Take your spoon.
You took your spoon. Oh, here. Kind of I need to go in too.
Now this is something, this is my secret that Grammy does not use at all. Oh, that. Oh, and yes. I just realized we need relish. So, Connor, can you borrow that relish from Grammy? Yeah, so a little bit of salt. Connor, would you like to squirt on that relish? Mm-hmm. Go ahead and squirt on the relish.
Not too much. Here.
I think we can use the rest of this. Let's untie it. Let's just untie it and let it out. empty out that relish onto there. And it's already seasoned. Oh my God. Once you mix it all together, taste a little bit of that, Connor.
It's really good.
Wow. Yeah, good. You are so funny.
Now we're gonna press the button.
Hold on. Now, what we're gonna press on our Hamilton Beach blender food processor. What we're gonna press on our Hamilton Beach food processor is we're gonna press puree. Just for a second, because we want it to get a certain consistency of it. So go ahead and press that counter button. So you can see the consistency of it on the outer end. You can see how finely everything gets chopped, and then you can judge. So I feel like everything is pretty chopped good. Thank you, sweetheart.
Wow, that was so nice, Connor.
Oh, yes.
I'm just gonna scoop and put it in the egg.
Oh, you're so good, Connor.
Just like Grammy's doing.
Just like Grammy's doing, except ours.
He's a little behind.
Yeah. Grammy's a little behind because she's old school. What do you do, Connor?
Just scoop it and keep scooping it. Scooping the thing and putting it in the eggs.
Exactly. That's exactly what you do, Mommy. A little bit of paprika goes a long way. Just for the... This is literally from Grammy because I feel like, honestly, comment below if you feel like I feel. Paprika does paprika, however you guys may say it, does nothing for the taste. I don't taste anything. I feel like it's so bland, but it's the look for it, and you can definitely sprinkle some on there. And we are done with our double eggs. Okay. Grammy wins on the presentation. I suck. Grammy wins. Hers look amazing. They look so good. Mine look crazy. I don't know. So we're gonna have Connor eat the eggs and tell us which one tastes the best.
And the winner.
Yes, and the winner.
Okay.
Go ahead, Mommy.
Come on, take a bite from each egg.
I'm gonna take a bite of the eggs too, because
I need to take out of it.
No, you gotta take a bite from the next egg and see which one tastes better.
Okay,
now the next egg.
I need to finish swallowing this.
Oh my goodness, yes, please.
Grammy was trying to choke you.
No.
Oh, Grammy's is so filled, right? With all that yolk. Hers is freaking yummy.
The winner is...
Oh my God.
Is...
Dum, dum, dum. I can't look.
Pick the egg. Pick which egg is the winner. That's the way
the winner is...
Mine.
Thank you, Connor.
It's fixed.
Yeah. Yes. So.
We both have a beautiful two platters of eggs.
Yeah, I'm actually going to eat some of Grammy's eggs because this is the original recipe.
They're really good.
Yeah,
Grammy's are really good.
I already know.
She like filled it all up.
She is the OG of eggs.
Mom, you got it on some of your nails.
It's fine.
Now, Kyle. You have not tasted the eggs.
No.
So?
Well, you have to come taste the eggs.
You have to come taste the egg, huh?
So, come on, Kyle.
Mm-hmm.
Up and taste the eggs. Here.
Why do they call it deviled eggs?
Because the devil made them.
I have no idea.
I actually don't know what
deviled eggs.
Okay.
That's
right,
good.
See, you don't know which
right,
one is which.
Right, we don't want you to know which is which. You know. You'll know when you taste it. You'll say, okay. I say okay, too.
I gotta work on my
additives. He said that one was really good.
You want to eat the rest of that? Because I'm not going to stuff it with nothing. And nobody used a spoon.
The second one's a lot creamier. I like the second one.
Eggs.
A second one's a lot. The second one was Grammy's recipe.
Tal said the second one's a lot better. It's creamier.
I think that me and Grammy have tied.
I like the second one more.
Yeah, I think me and Grammy have tied. She has the OG recipe, you guys. And like I said, I think a big difference between hers and I and mine's is that she uses the best food mayonnaise, which is, I mean, you can't top mayonnaise. But, you know, like for me, who's cutting down on mayonnaise, I think these are a great substitute.
Enjoy yourself. Because some mama done already told me what to left over bring
to
her.
Twice.
Right. You have all these generations right here. So I hope you guys enjoy, like, subscribe. And what else, Connor? What do you tell them?
Comments down below.
Comments down below and like and subscribe, right? Yeah. Okay, and thank you for cooking with us.
In case you like my mom's video, she'll be your friend. For sure.
And if you want to see me back, just put it right along with your suggestions.
And if you want her number, I'll tell you.
Okay. Wait, what?
I'll tell you.
Thank you.